Welcome back to Halftime TV, Norando Brunier, your host. And before we go any further, please remember to hit that subscribe button and leave your comments in the comment section below. In the week that was, Manchester United and Chelsea played to a stalemate. Real Madrid came out victors in the El Clasico, however, they yet to win a game in the European competition. Bayern Munich, on the other hand, are unstoppable and there's no slowing down based on what I'm seeing. Chelsea's new signing, Edouard Mendy, becomes the first goalkeeper since legend Peter Cech to have 4 clean sheets in his first 5 games. And the big news that has had everyone talking this week is Bartomeu leaving Barcelona. What this means is Lionel Messi steps away victorious once more. As we alluded to in one of our previous episodes, we didn't expect Bartomeu to retain this seat as Barcelona president. However, we didn't expect him to leave so soon either. In departing, he made quite the statement, and he went as far as indicating that Barcelona had signed off on a European Super League competition. The intricacies of this would be similar to that of the NBA or the NFL in the United States of America, but I won't delve too much into it because as of now, it's gibberish for the most part. Reigning Premier League champions Liverpool are down to just one senior centre-half as Fabinho limped off injured midweek in their Champions League fixture. What this means is Jurgen Klopp will have his work cut out going forward, as with 6 games into the 2020-2021 season and only one fit senior defender, it is merely impossible for them to retain the title. At least that's how it seems from where I'm sitting. Having observed all these games throughout the past week, I bring your attention to 2 very important words that we use week in, week out in assessing sports. Ability and appetite. Now, ability comes from the Latin word habilis, which means having the skill or opportunity to do something. Appetite is an amalgamation of 2 Latin words, ad, which means to, and perere, which means seek. So, in essence, appetite means to seek. We've seen a number of tremendous athletes throughout the past few decades. However, only a handful of these have maximized their potential. Why is this so though? Why is this happening? Why do we constantly see this day in, day out? We're watching the English Premier League or La Liga or Serie A, and we see some prodigies, and 2 years down the line or 6 months down the line or even 5 years down the line, they vanish from the map, and then we're wondering what happened to that phenomenon talent. It goes back to the aforementioned words, appetite versus ability. Or whichever way you want to put it, ability versus appetite. I'll use Cristiano Ronaldo and Lionel Messi as reference points, after which I'll allude to some other prominent athletes throughout the past few years who we've seen come and go. Now, Cristiano Ronaldo, we can argue, has less talent than Lionel Messi. However, it is the drive or the appetite that keeps him going, that keeps him competitive, and that has propelled him to the top next to Lionel Messi. Messi, on the other hand, is more talented, and as such, he uses the appetite for the game to balance the tremendous amount of talent or ability he has. To some, I may not be making any sense, but if we think about it for a second, we'll realize that it is exactly the case. I've seen some extraordinary players for the 20 or so years that I've been a fan of football, but not all these players have maximized their potential. Hatem Ben Arfa, for example, reference point. This was one of the most talented players that I've witnessed play football. For those who didn't watch him, they may say, okay, he was a flop. He was at Newcastle. And even if you pay attention to the teams that he's been to, it may not be as glamorous on paper. But I guarantee you, if you should go back and watch some of the clips or even some of the full games that this player has played, you realize that he was definitely a gem in the rough. James Milner. On the flip side, he's not one of the most talented players you'll see, but he's an extremely hard worker. As a result, he's been playing at the top for the past 10 years, and it doesn't seem as if he's slowing down anytime soon. What's the difference between these two players? One needs to understand how to strike a balance between talent or ability and appetite. And then it goes back to the same discussion of talent versus hard work, which is more important. I tend to be on the fence in this topic because neither is more important in my opinion, because if you are an extremely hard worker, you can use that drive and that appetite or that need for success to tie it in with the little bit of talent that you have or even if you don't have any talent whatsoever, you still can be a hard worker and be successful in whatever you do, in this particular case in sports. Mario Balotelli is another example of talent gone to waste. At 30 years old, he's exhausted every option possible and now back at square one. He was one of the most phenomenal talents 10 years ago. We were talking about and everyone was expecting great things of him because that's how talented he was. He, however, lacked discipline and the urge and the drive to work hard. And as a result, he is where he is now. Paul Pogba, another example. He's arguably one of the most talented midfielders in the world as we speak. But is he world class? No. And one may say, how can he be one of the most talented midfielders on the planet and not be a world class player? Now, in my opinion, being a world-class player is showing up every week and showcasing that talent that is so talked about every week. It is the consistency and the urge, the drive, the appetite to stay at the top. Paul Pogba has not shown this. And since his move to Manchester United from Juventus, I've only seen glimpses. He plays when he feels like, and that's not how it's supposed to go. Stroll across the city, Manchester City. We see Kevin De Bruyne. He shows up week in, week out, and although he is one of the most talented there is, he still works extremely hard and showcases why he is touted to be the best to have ever played in a Manchester City shirt. Overall, he is the best midfielder in England. Talent-wise, he's up there with the best in the world. But it is the work ethic and the willingness to be better than he was last game and even better the game ahead. Paul Pogba needs to emulate this. He needs to take a page from Kevin De Bruyne's book. A player rejected and cast aside, went elsewhere to prove himself, and now he's back in the English league, dominating. Manchester United buying Paul Pogba when they did was supposed to be a stepping stone in his career. Instead, he's stagnated. He's not improved one bit since his move a few years ago. And it begs the question, was this a waste of money? Is Manchester United wasting their time? We see him being extraordinary with the French national team, yet when he pulls on the Manchester United shirt, you're wondering, should he be the one out there, the center of attention? Because having done all he's done last season and the season before, Bruno Fernandes, a man brought in January, was the player of the season and seems to be the catalyst in this Manchester United team. In closing, I say this to young aspiring athletes. Talent is not more important than work ethic. And neither is work ethic more important than talent. We need to learn how to strike a balance in using one to suffice for the other's shortcomings. And this is synonymous with appetite and ability. You may have all the ability or the talent in the world. If you're not willing to work hard, and if you don't have that appetite and that drive, you'll be falling into the same trap as a number of athletes before you. Hatem Ben Arfa, Mario Balotelli, Andre Schürrle, Adnan Januzaj, just to name a few. Thanks once more to our sponsors, Quicklink Shipping. Follow them on Instagram at Quicklink Shipping or email them at quickshipping@gmail.com. CSA Shop, be free, be confident. CSA Shop located in the heart of Mandeville. Follow them on Instagram at CSA Shop or email them at csashop@aol.com. RS Sports Store, RS Sports Store, get in the game. Follow them on Instagram at RS Sports Store. And follow the instructions in our description for our Predict and Win competition. Predict and Win is sponsored by RS Sports Store. Norando Brown here saying thanks for tuning in to another episode. And please remember to like, share, and subscribe. Until next time.